Hey guys, how's it going? Huh? Let's try this again. Hey guys, how's it going? Previously on the channel, I had uploaded a video on this Cub Cadet. It's a 105. We were working on it. Had some issues. We got it off of a guy, paid $150 for it. He came here to buy some parts, had it in the truck. Didn't really expect to buy it. Didn't really expect him to bring it. But it was just one of them things I couldn't pass up. My brother owns some 482s, and back when I was little, my dad used to have a Cub Cadet. We used to have a 3000 series. I think it was a 3802, if I'm correct. It was a garden tractor. I think it was an 01, I think. It was a good tractor. We had it for, we had it 13 years, something like that. The transmission ended up going out on it, unfortunately. So I think he was going to have it rebuilt, but I guess he really never got around to it. And he ended up getting a zero turn because I'm not sure. I guess we just wanted to try one out or something. I'm not sure. But he ended up getting that, and this is when we moved into the new house. So this was a few years ago. So we got the zero turn and we used it. And then I started collecting tractors, and you guys know the rest. So that's why I wanted a Cub Cadet. I would like to find a 3000 series like what we used to have. It had a snowblower, mower deck, or no, it had a snowplow and a mower deck. So I've been looking around, but I really haven't seen any. That's one of the things on my bucket list, is to find one of them like what he had. And then also the black Chevy we used to have before he passed away. So anyway, off that topic. I don't feel like crying on camera. In the last video, we were working on this Cub Cadet 105. And I really want to thank you guys. I really appreciate it. I wasn't expecting as many answers as I got. I posted a video. As much as I didn't want to, and as much as I wanted to keep this tractor a secret, I posted a video on the channel right when I was working on this, because I had it going backwards, but I couldn't get it to go forwards. So I posted a video, and I had a few people tell me it was the relief valves that was causing it. They might need to be rebuilt, or they might need to be cleaned up. So I want to thank you guys, all of you who helped with that. I really do appreciate it. It doesn't go unnoticed. I really want to thank you guys. I love my subscribers. You guys are awesome. Especially all the help that you guys give me. I really do appreciate it. Sometimes you got to step down from your castle and ask for help. So, not that I'm in a castle, you know. It's just, I don't know what I was talking about. Anyway, so, yeah, I posted a video about that, and I had quite a few people give me some suggestions, so I really do appreciate it, like I said. So we are going to go on ahead and get back into this Cub. In the last video, we were working on the battery. We were trying to get the battery to take a charge. It took a charge, but it just doesn't have the cranking amps it needs to turn over the engine. So that battery is no good. No carburetor. It's also missing an oil dipstick. I don't know how much oil's in it. We put a coil on it also. Going underneath. We checked the gas tank. Gas tank looked good. I think that's it. So, we put a tube in, I think it was this tire. I think it was that tire, right? Yeah, it was. They both have tubes. No, never mind. Yeah, it was this one. We put a tube in this tire, then we put it up on the forklift. I was going to disconnect the drive linkage and see if maybe we could get it to, maybe the drive linkage needed adjusted, but I couldn't unhook it, so I just left it on there. And then I think that is where I ended the video. So, we are going to try and see if we can figure out how to get to the relief valves, and we are going to see if maybe that's our problem. So, like I said, I do want to thank you guys for the help. I really do appreciate it. So we are going to be, I'm not quite sure how to get this taken apart. Somebody told, one of the people in the comments told me that all the fenders need to come off, all the tins need to come off. I don't know if the dash does. Right here is where the thing is, so I'm going to guess this probably has to come off. Unless it goes back and the valves are right there, which it could be. So, let's see how we get these off of here. Right there, there, there. What does that take off? Does that take off the fender assembly, or does that just take off? Let's see. There's a couple right there. Actually, wait a minute. I bet you them right there hold the... Well, is there a way to do it without taking all the skins off? Let me put you guys in the stand. We'll take a look at it. I guess we'll see what we can find. Maybe we'll get it figured out. I think I am going to make a grill for the front. If I'm correct, the grill needs to be white. I'm pretty sure of that. And I've got some metal back here. I wish I had a sheet with holes in it, with round holes in it, like what they are supposed to be, but I guess this will work. Take some of this, cut it up, and stick that on there. What do you think? Think that would look good? Cut it down real nice and stick it in there. I think that would look pretty damn good. Yeah, I think it goes up against the sleeve, if I'm correct. That's what holds it in. Then you put a screw and a nut and a bolt through here and over here too, I think. So I am going to look for a grill. If I can find a grill for it, I'll go that route. If I can't, I guess it really doesn't matter whether it's got a grill or not, but makes it look cool. Then we'd take it and paint it. It would look new. That's the only thing. Let's see if we can figure these tins out back here. I think the wheel more than likely is going to have to come off in order to get the skins on both sides. Here's one, here's one, there, there, there. What's up here? There's a nut up in there. Looks like it might be welded, no? Maybe that doesn't need to come off there. It doesn't feel like it's... This is a part of the frame. How do you get... I think that just holds on the fenders. Okay, no, we don't need to take them out, I don't think. Those look like they just hold the fenders. Right here is a plate. On this side, too, is a plate. I thought there was. There might not be. No, there's not. It's just right here. I wonder what that plate does. Do we want to take it out and find out?
You guys said yes?
Okay.
Let me grab...
I think it might be a 7/16. 3/8. One of these two.
3/8.
Never mind. We only had one. That's for the transmission. I see. It's got a little bit more ways to go. Okay. Not a lot. Yeah. So we just uncovered the thing that. I don't really think we need that one covered, so I'm going to cover that back up. Flathead bolts here. I wonder what they get to. What do you guys think? I'm trying to think how that thing would come off. I don't think that we got to take the thing off of there, but we might. Does the dash need to come off at all? 1, 2, 3, 4. Probably take the dash off, then this comes off. Looks like it actually goes underneath this as well, so that looks like it's got to come off. But how does that come off? That's what I'm trying to figure out.
This is its own piece. This under here is held on by a nut. Same with all these other bolts under here, so that can't be how to get this assembly off. It's got to be further in. You don't take the seat out to do, no? Maybe you do. We really got ourselves a project.
Why couldn't they just put them on the bottom of the transmission? Let me look at it a little bit more. My battery and the camera starting to go. And as you guys know, I'm down to one battery currently. So I will bring you guys back here later on once I find something. So I'll be back. Well, you guys missed a little bit. You're probably wondering where the Cub went. Unfortunately, somebody who watched my video earlier came by the shop and they offered me, they asked me if I still had the Cub. They made me an offer on it. I said, sure. So unfortunately, I sold it. It's gone. Haha, just kidding. It's sitting out here, don't worry, I still have it. You guys have missed a little bit since you guys have been here. The camera battery quit on me. So I kind of started getting into it myself just to see what I could find, because I wasn't going to sit there and wait for the battery to charge. So I started looking around on it, and I figured out how to get the seat pan off of it. And got that off there, started messing with it. Got the valve freed up. The valve over here was stuck. Got it unstuck. Now it moves. I tested the tractor. It does go forwards now. So that is all fixed. I want to thank everybody, like I said, for the suggestions on the video that I made previously. It ended up being that valve was just stuck. Got that freed up, however. Now it moves. It goes forwards. It goes backwards. Everything on it seems to work good now. So perfect. So I am going to go on ahead and get this mounted back up. If you're wondering how to get the seat pan off your Cub, there's a couple bolts down. There's four bolts down there. They go into the footwells. Underneath here, there's some bolts up here and here underneath this pan. Then there's a couple right there and a couple right there. That's all covered up by that panel underneath. And then that panel on top goes over where I think that's where you put fluid in the transmission. Again, I think that's where you put the fluid in. Again, I'm not completely sure, but that's where that cover goes. Then the other cover goes up above it. So there you go. I'm going to go on ahead and get this Cub put back together. I just wanted to let you guys know I got it figured out. Here's the mower deck. I think I'm going to get that put back together. And I think next what we are going to do is we are going to order a carburetor for it, and I'm also going to look for a dipstick. And after I find a dipstick and a carburetor for it and a battery, we should be able to use it. I'd like to get it running, but I don't have a carburetor. I could steal the one off the 312 if I wanted to, since it's not really running right now. The transmission's got problems, but I'm just going to leave it alone. I have it pretty well dialed in for that motor. That motor, for whatever reason, likes it, is pretty picky. So I'd rather not fight with it. So I'm just gonna leave it alone. I'm gonna order a new one for this. I may end up taking the one off the 73 and throwing the new one on it and putting that one on here, because I do think the 73 needs a new carb. It probably wouldn't be a bad idea. I'll probably just get a new carburetor for this and say forget it. So let me go on ahead and get everything put back on here. I'm pretty sure you guys want to see that, but I'm just going to go on ahead and do it off camera. So I might time lapse it, but it's just so much easier to do off camera. Let me set the camera up, I guess, and I'll time lapse it so you guys can watch. guys, felt like it took nearly forever, but I got that all on there and situated. Gonna put you guys on hold for a little while. I'm gonna start looking around for a carburetor and also a oil dipstick. So hopefully here soon we should be back on this project. But for right now, I'm gonna pull the plug on it. If I end up needing to, I'll stop the video here and I'll continue it later on. We can work on it a little bit more. So I will bring you guys back here later. If I don't bring you guys back, this is the end of the video. Thank you guys for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. I know we really didn't do much in this video, but like I said, I probably just didn't want to finish it, so I decided to end it. So, all right, that's it. Take care. So I sat down and did some deciding last night. I was looking around for dipsticks. I couldn't find any dipsticks that I needed. So I had the idea. I took this one right here. This one came out of a 12 horse and it goes up. It's one of them that goes up, where the one that we need goes through the cam gear cover. So I took it in there and I stuck it down in the engine and I just stopped. Came back out full of oil, so I went in a little bit more and I hit the bottom. So we need to cut it right here. This is about where we need to cut the dipstick. But if I do that, then the only problem is we're not gonna be able to get, we're gonna have to bend this over, put a handle here, and then this still won't be in the oil. So I did a little bit of thinking. And I found this guy upstairs. He is one that has a busted off head. What we could even do is measure this down here, see how long it needs to be, and then come up here, measure this, and then cut it. We could do that too. But I want to get this one, something done with it. So we're gonna cut this top off here. I already took the other assembly off of it. The top of this one was broke, so I thought, well, we could use that one for something. So that's what I'm gonna do with it. If we don't lose it, need a better pair of looks like. Found that upstairs. I think I found another carburetor also over in the other barn. So I'm gonna grab, why is that not? I'm gonna grab that. Now let's. There we go. Now I got it off. So now let's find how long we need it to be right here. So we need to find. Can we cut up here? Straighten these out, make a handle out of them? We could probably do that. While I'm thinking about it, we need a way to secure this. Oh, actually, hold on a minute. Let's cut it up here. Well, yeah, we could flatten that out. So let's see if we can flatten this guy out. If we can, then we'll make a thing up top. There was one that I saw, but it was the complete assembly, which I really don't want. And it was going for, I think they had it up for $60 or $70. So I thought, yeah, that's ridiculous. So we're gonna do it this way instead. I think this way would be, I just wanted a dipstick, you know, I didn't want the entire assembly. This was all I really needed. Whatever, that needs to go on last anyway. And here's our top cover. Stick it right there. Because that's, needs to go up a little more actually. And after, there we go, we got it up a little bit of the ways. Okay, that's good.
Oh, and I also found a carburetor, so I think I told you guys about that, but I don't remember. So if I didn't, now you know.
So there we go.
We have our carburetors. We have our
setup pretty much figured out now. Where is that piece?
Oh, there's another one over here. Here, we'll just use this one. So, oh, it's already got a thing in it too.
Yeah.
I didn't see that. Let me see if I can find. I think it rolled away quite a lot because I don't see it. So I guess we'll use that one. If we end up deciding to, we can probably take this out up here because that right there looks to have the piece on it we need already. See that right there, that rubber? So we stick that on. Yeah, looks like it might work. Maybe we'll do that instead. Now we just got to put something here to hold that. I'm looking for something. We could probably drill a hole right there, put something in it, or drill a hole there, put this back up here, put something in there. I don't know if I can see that coming out or not. I think we'll be okay with it how it is. You know, as long as our little dipstick works out good, then yeah, that's going to be an issue. Okay, yeah, so maybe we could put a little bend in if we can get this to go up a little further. Put a little bit of a put a little bit of a bend in our stick. That'll hold it up. I don't know if I want to do that or not. That's enough. No, that won't hold it. Damn. Oh well. We'll figure something out. Let's just go without that for now. How's that do? That one holds itself up okay. Looks like it's a little bit bigger. Put something right here. Let me see if the Horde has something to offer. If it doesn't, I guess we'll just kind of go with it. Unfortunately, I couldn't find anything, but this isn't the prettiest thing in the world. But it'll definitely work. You can pull it out, check it, put it back in. Let's go on ahead and try our dipstick out. Let's see how it does. So let's see. Let me turn on the light. There's a light on, but it throws off the camera. Grab the light. Ready? Yeah, I don't worry about that. This one doesn't want to go in, so we got to use the other one. I was kind of worried about that. We'll give this one more chance. If it don't, then oh well. Yeah, it just stays in there. That's okay, I guess. It doesn't even. gonna pop out of there whenever it wants, you know, but I don't know, maybe it'll be okay. I guess we'll find out here later on. I definitely do need to do something about that though. So, it's got a dipstick now at least, so I'm a little bit happier about it. Let me go grab a carburetor and we'll get that carburetor put on there. A little bit of an update for you guys. It has been kind of hot in here, so I've been running the fan all day. Got it kicked down low right now. I had it on. I didn't film because I didn't want to hear the wind noise in the camera. Plus, I'm sure you guys probably don't either. So a little bit of an update for you guys. I started working on this. I got the carburetor put on. Had one up front, went up there and grabbed it. Also got the oil dipstick made and put on there. Not really happy with the dipstick, but I guess it's gonna work. I think that is just about it. I also got a carburetor put on there. I got an air filter on there. No gas in the tank yet though. Now we gotta try it out, put a different battery in it, see if it's got spark, and if it's got spark, then maybe it'll run. Still has that junk battery in it, but I want to see if we can get it to have spark. If it has spark, we're going to try it and see if we can get the motor to fire over at least once. And then once it starts, we'll take the charger off of it. And maybe if it starts, it'll keep itself running. The generator will put enough power out to keep it running. I don't know if it will. I kind of hope it does. I don't like doing this, but I'm going to put this on boost just to help it a little bit. So I need to find my spark. Stick this on here and we'll see how it cranks. Not cranks, but we'll see if it sparks. If it sparks, we'll put some gas down that cylinder and we'll try it out. If it don't, which I am expecting it not to, then we'll just take it and we will have to pull the points cover off and we'll check under the points. We'll see what the points look like. Ready? I don't think I have it set up. I do know that coil should be good. I don't think it's the coil. Let's try it again. Ready? So let's take the points cover off. Let's get a look at the points. I cannot find my feeler gauges at the moment. So I guess we'll just have to go with, hopefully, they're in adjustment. They just need cleaned up. If it doesn't end up being the points, it's something further in. So we'll have to figure that out. Let's see what we get. Go ahead and get that points cover off. There it is. If this thing runs good and drives good, maybe we'll throw the mower deck on it later and see how it moves. I do need to get the pressure washer out and pressure wash it. Them points actually don't look half bad at all. Yeah, they do show a little bit of corrosion, but let's see. We can get this little guy to do our job for us. Oops. Nope, guess not. It's not thick enough. Maybe one more. One more try. Oh, it's just gonna rip. So, okay. Yeah, like I figured. Here we go. Don't want to sand it down, but I just want to clean it up a little. So I've got a piece of sandpaper right here. We'll do that a couple times. Yeah, see, look at what came off that. But yeah, maybe that'll do what we need or what we want it to, and then it should be. See, that came off the top. See if that does it. Maybe that'll give us some spark. Ready? Unfortunately, it don't, but I thought I heard some. Watch the points. Oh, it is sparking. Just not very well. Okay, so it's a little bit weak, but it could be because that metal it's on is corroded. I thought I heard a spark. So let me bring you guys up. I'm gonna grab my little gas can. We'll put some gas in the cylinder and see how it does. Guys, ready to see how it'll do? Put a little bit of gas down our cylinder. That's probably enough. Might take it a little bit to get it to go, but hopefully it should take off real quick. Ready? Here we go. Here goes nothing. Firing, but I don't think I put much gas in it to begin with. So, all right, that should be enough.
A lot better than before.
We'll see if it goes on that. Let's try again. And maybe now it'll decide it wants to go. Ready? Here we go. There it goes. Good try. Almost. So it does run. Let's put some gas in the tank and I don't know, maybe it'll start. So I will bring you guys back after I do that. That's exciting. Put some gas in it. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the
like it was slowly filling up. No, that looks, that's good. Well, I don't see any leaks.
What do you guys think? You want to try it?
Let's do it.
Ready?
Let's see if it'll start.
If it starts, awesome. If it don't, well, we're missing something. Ready? Oh, I know why I quit. I turned the voltage down, that's why. Yeah, see, I turned down the voltage. It wasn't getting enough voltage to go.
Let's try it again. Maybe it'll start.
Did go, though. Ready? Oh, maybe it had a little bit in it from earlier. Maybe that's why. Let's see. Ready? Getting enough power from my little thing over there. I don't know. There it goes. So it's been a couple days since the last time you guys have seen this tractor. Been having some problems with it lately. When you guys were last here, it was started and it was running fine. And I shut the camera off to move some things. And it turned off like I turned off the key. So I thought, okay, it probably ran out of gas. So, checked the gas. Gas was full. Tried starting it up. Wouldn't start. Checked it for spark, had no spark. So from there, we have been going over things. I mean me. I was put a different coil on it. That didn't help it. Put different points on it. That didn't help it. Spark plug wire. I have gone through and messed with everything. I started testing things. I don't know why I didn't film it. But I went over it, I did a spark plug, I did a whole bunch of stuff working on it. One thing that really has thrown me off is I was messing with it the other day. I've never had this happen before until this started. That should not be all like that. So it is bending spark plugs now. So, trying to figure out what's going on with it. I cannot get it to run. It does have spark, however. So, not quite sure what I want to go from here. We had it running, but unfortunately now we're having an issue with it. I'm not sure what the deal is. Friend of mine has lead on a 1975 John Deere 210. He said he doesn't need the motor for anything. He's asking if I want the motor. Because it almost sounded like this engine had a knock to it. I don't think it had a knock, but it was making some funny noises that, and now I can't get it to run. So I don't know what we're going to do. But it's bending spark plugs, it won't start. I threaded the spark plug out a little bit, tried to get it to start, had spark, had compression, had fuel, everything. The plug came out wet, and I know it had spark.
So something's not right there. Let me grab another known good spark plug and we'll throw it in there and we'll try to see if we can get it to start back up. So that's what has been going on while you guys have been away. Not really much has happened. It hasn't ran since last time you guys were here. I did get it to fire off a couple of times, but that was just about it. So I ended up taking the points off the 312 and putting them on here. I think that is just about it. So I will put you guys in the stand. I'm gonna go grab another spark plug. We're gonna throw it in there, put some gas in there and see what we get. See, now that I'm filming, it's gonna prove me a liar and it's gonna start. Check this plug and see if it has spark. Yes, we're in. Ready? Has spark, but then it goes away. Let's try it again, buddy. No spark at all now. I think we're missing something. Again. We get sparked for a little bit, then it goes away. I wonder. You know, you guys probably want to see. We'll grab our plug that we bent earlier. We'll see if it has any spark. If it sparks, something's wrong. Not horribly wrong, but we're not right. Ready? Okay, no spark from that one either. Where earlier, that was the only one that was sparking. Let me check the point gap. Again, I really don't want to mess with the points, but since they did come off the 312 and I had it running just about perfect before, but you figure, well, might as well since we're fiddling with it. That's 20. No, it's off a little bit actually. Let me make it a little bit tighter. A little bit looser, actually. See that little gap though, doing that. This could have something to do with it too. I'll take that out for now. That is 20. So let's try that. This one. Let's try that. Now that it's at 20. I had it a little bit small before, I guess. Ready? I definitely feel like we should be getting a lot more than that, but we're getting spark now, so I guess I'm just gonna leave it like that. Let me bring you guys back some. Yeah, we're getting spark, so we'll just leave it like that for now. Watch this thing prove me a liar.
Well, I ain't gonna bend that plug.
This, I don't know, this tractor has really been testing my patience lately. Do I even have any more two-strip? Not a lot, but maybe it'll be enough. Oh well. That might be enough to get it to at least taste something. Found another little candidate, two-stroke, but it's just regular gas, but it's another little can. I'll use this one. I'd rather do two-stroke, but I don't know. That was a lot. Yeah, that was a lot. Oops. I guess I shouldn't have quite flooded it. Let's just go with that. Let's see what that does. Again, don't put it in far enough where it'll bend my plug, but put it in far enough where it'll do something at least. Ready? Let's see what we get. See if we get, let's see if the plug is wet when we pull it out. No, it's dry. Ready? Well, now we have no spark. Nothing. So I have no idea, and I'm losing my patience with this thing. I'm losing them fast. So now we have no spark. We have spark at the points. No spark at the plug. I'm having that problem again. I had that issue once before. I can't remember how I solved it. Let me unhook the condenser. Yeah, I've had that issue once before where it was sparking at the points but not the plug. I solved it, but I don't remember how. And I think after I solved it, I lost spark again, so. See what that does.
unhooked to the condenser. But I don't get why it's sparking at the points. Well, I unhooked the condenser, now I'm not getting any of them. Okay, I'm getting spark at the points. How about up here? Nothing. And I know this is a good wire. So it's not the wire. And it's not the condenser. What is causing it? It can't be the coil, I don't think. I may end up going and grabbing another coil off something else. You know what? What tractor do I want to pull the coil off? Let me go grab a coil that I know is good. I really don't want to pull it, but I will. The 73 is going to be without a coil for a little bit. Went ahead and I stuck that coil on there from the 68. Hopefully we'll be able to get something out of it now. I kind of doubt it with the luck I've been having, but I guess we'll try it and see. Ready? Well, we got spark. I don't know if you guys saw that or not. I think you did. So we're getting spark, so it must have been the coil. Let's put this plug in and let's see if we get anything out of that. If it'll start up or not. If it does, cool. If it doesn't, damn. We'll have to plan something. Let me put this gas from this tank into this other tank, my two-stroke tank, so I can mix up some two-stroke here later on. Later on, I'll have to mix another batch of two-stroke. Let's go on ahead, dump a little bit of gas in here. Let's see what we get. I doubt we'll get anything, but you never know until you test your luck out and find out. And seeing as we're bending spark plugs, can't be that good. There we go. Ready? Let's see if it starts. Yeah, I'm wondering if it just burned out all its gas. Let me try it again. It did start, however. So, just open that. Ready?
way, we'll try backing it out. I think I know why it wants to run. It's currently raining. I don't want my camera getting wet. We're gonna go up and down the driveway like usual, since it wants to run now. Idling. I need to adjust the idle and the throttle while I'm at it. I hate this part. pretty nice. For those of you wondering, that noise is the PTO up in the front. Something up there rattles. I'm not sure what it is, but something in the front rattles. Hopefully here soon it'll go away. Let's try and adjust it. Full throttle, it's kind of low. Should be okay. I'm gonna put something different on that air filter. You can see that's not quite that good.
Well, guys, I think this is where I'm going to end the video. I want to thank you guys for watching, hanging out with me today in the shop. Found out the running issue that it was having. It was having a little bit of an issue. The carburetor was loose. Apparently, we must not have bolted it down all the way. Because it, well, in the video, it ran okay, but I took it and I drove it around a little bit after I shut the camera off. And it was having some issues. It wouldn't really throttle very well. It wasn't idling good. It was jumpy. So I started looking at it and adjusting the carb, and I noticed the carb moving around. So I tightened it up. Now it's on there tight, so it don't move around anymore. Now I'm having another issue. I'm sure you guys see the battery out. I'm currently trying to solve a ground issue. I was out there using it, and I shut it off, and the generator was still turning when the key was turned off. So got to figure out what's going on there. I don't think I'm going to film it. I'll tell you guys what's wrong with it, but I'm not going to film it because I'm sure you guys probably don't care. So thank you guys for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. Really appreciate you guys coming out, hanging out with me in the shop, working on some more junk. Another Cub to add to the list. This time we've got one running. Probably here in the next video that you guys see, we are going to be diving into this mower deck and seeing if maybe we can get it to mow. And if we can get it to mow, we'll put the deck back on it and test it out. Probably gonna end up putting some bar tires on this beast. And I don't know what I'm gonna take them off of, but I'm gonna take some bar tires off something. Probably end up taking them off the patio. I really don't wanna do that. But more than likely, I'll end up taking them bar tires off the patio and putting a different set of rear tires on it so that we can put some bars on this. I want to test them bars out and see how they are. So, okay. Thank you guys for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. Really appreciate you guys coming out to the shop and hanging out with me today working on this thing. We got it running finally after cussing about and having a bunch of issues with it. Well, now that we've fixed one problem, we gotta have another. So I guess that's it. Take care.